Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection, because perfection doesn't exist. Today I want to share more products that actually just do what they say they're gonna do, products that actually work. We know there are a lot of brands, a lot of products that make fake promises when it comes to what they can do for our skin. And as you know, I test out all these products so you don't have to. So today I want to share some of the more recent products I've been using that just work. As simple as that sounds, they just do what they're supposed to do. I've talked about this product on and off for more than a year now, sponsored and unsponsored. This is the Foreo Luna 3, and I've been using this again on and off for about 17 months now. It's been quite a long time. And I love this for a few reasons. Number one, this probably shouldn't be the number one reason, but you only have to charge this once. And I know that sounds super stupid, but I'm the type of person to use any electrical item until they die and then be without it for a few hours while it has to charge up, including like my headphones, my phone. And I haven't charged this. It says it only needs one charge a year, but I haven't charged this since I've got it. And as I said, I've been using it for about 17 months. That's just super handy. The next point is that it's also made from silicone. And you may be thinking, don't touch it. But this makes all the difference because it's gentler, first of all, compared to those other facial brushes, like the electronic ones that have the bristles and it's kind of harsh. I know when I used to use those, I used to feel an immediate urge to scrub at my skin. This doesn't make you do that. And because of the silicone, it doesn't grow or harbor bacteria. It's super easy to clean. You just run it under the sink and then you're done. Meaning this can also sit in your bathroom without any worries of it becoming unclean. And you can touch it without becoming unclean. And unlike spinning brushes, you don't have to repurchase brush heads all the time. When I talked about this last time, I think it was an Instagram live, a lot of people were like, oh, it's kind of pricey. But once you've bought this, you've bought it. You don't have to repurchase new heads every month or however much they recommend. But once you got this, there's no extra monthly cost to it. You've just got your device and that's it. You get such a nice effective cleanse from this that's really, really light on the skin. It very gently removes dead skin as well as just gives you a nice natural glow. And it also helps clean under my beard in a few places. For the very few men that watch my channel, it's really, really good for that. The place where I've noticed the biggest difference is the place where my pores tend to look more congested and enlarged. What is this like? Pre-nose, corner of the nose is on my nose itself and in the center of my forehead here, especially during summer when my skin would look super, super congested and my oily skin goes super oily. When you use this with the app as well, just make sure you cleanse everywhere. You spend a few seconds on your forehead, on your cheek, another cheek, and then this kind of like middle area here. The T-Sonic pulsations get to work and give you a really good cleanse. 1 minute and you're done, and that's all it takes, and you get a very good cleanse. So I love this. The next product is the M Cosmetics Face Cuddle Moisture Balm. This is a relatively new product, as in a number of days, but there are some products that you don't need months to test and try to just know that they work. And this is one of them. This is a balm that helps lock in hydration. So think of this slugging trend that everyone's doing, CeraVe healing ointment, but this is very different. This feels so much lighter on the skin. And because it's in like this twist up stick, it's so much easier to use and get into all the crevices without having to dip your fingers into a tub and spread everywhere, you know? But this does form a nice occlusive layer without being heavy and sticky and your face sticking to your pillow. I've been using this on areas of my face where I wake up a little bit drier. So again, the corners of my nose, this monobrow area, middle of my forehead and down by the sides of my sideburns, because I wake up in the morning and I can feel the dryness in my skin, the lack of stretch in my skin, and I wake up in the morning with nice, dewy, cared for skin, no flakiness, no dryness, no irritation. And it's great for pretty much all of your body. I've been using it on my knuckles, on my hands, because they've been getting very dry. Ingredient wise, we have squalane, which is a skin identical ingredient because it's found naturally within our sebum. And I feel like this is really the key ingredient here that forms that occlusive layer, that light, non-greasy occlusive layer. And that's what I love about squalane oil. It's the only oil I could use at this stage in my life, especially my oily areas, because it is not greasy or heavy. We have Plucanitia volubilis seed oil, a plant oil containing essential fatty acids, as well as coffee seed oil, which is an interesting ingredient. Not many studies done behind it, but it's thought to help skin retain its moisture and is a possible antioxidant as well. Again, not a whole lot of evidence or studies behind this, but that doesn't mean it's not a promising ingredient. More studies just have to be done. M Cosmetics also launched a lip balm alongside this, I think. I don't know if they both came out at the same time, but I got both of them, the Lip Cushion Nourishing Balm, which I absolutely love as well. Next up, we have the Inkey Succinic Acid. So I love the Inkey List. We know that. I've done a few sponsored jobs with them recently, including a few sponsored posts for this product. But I want to talk about it in an unsponsored video because unfortunately a lot of people relate sponsored videos to lies for some reason. This is easily one of the best spot treatments I've ever used. As you may know, I stopped using spot treatments a long time ago because they tend to just dry down the spot and leave you with horrible, flaky, dry skin that, if you're like me, it leads to post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. You've got rid of the spot, but now you've got a whole other problem on your hand because you've got a massive dark spot on your face. So they actually sent this to me a few months before its launch date, and I was reluctant to try it at first because it was a spot treatment. Also, it contained sulfur and I had a bad reaction to what I thought was sulfur from a product from Wish Trend, I think it was. But one day I got a spot and I was like, right, I have to try it now because I might never get the chance. And oh my God, right? Listen, no product gets rid of your spot overnight, right? But this came very, very close. I remember putting it on. I had a spot somewhere up here. Put it on overnight. The next morning, I really struggled to find it. I was like, where has it gone? It was like playing a game of Where's Wally or Where's Waldo in America. I really had to search for this spot. It had taken down the redness. It's taken down the inflammation. It took away that angry kind of like boil look of the spot. No dry skin whatsoever. It smelled a little bit because it got sulfur in. So you do have that sulfury smell, but you kind of get a weird, like, it's slightly comforting in a way. So I went from using this on just one spot to actually spreading it all over my nose because I was looking a little bit congested again. I maybe used a few products that didn't agree with me and kind of like clogged me up a little bit. Used this and after a few days, my nose was looking so much better. This actually has 1% salicylic acid in it, which is known to obviously go deep within the pores and give them a good clean from the inside out. So listen, bin your drying lotions, keep your pimple patches. We still like those. But this is $6.99, which is a bargain. And you're going to use this way up to its expiry date because you just need a tiny bit on the spot, rub it in a little bit. Honestly, so, so good. Next, we have Glow Recipe. Watermelon Glow Niacinamide Dew Drops. This makes my skin look so good. It actually pisses me off a little bit. Because when I put this on, I'm like, this is how I want my skin to look all the time. And they've trapped me now. I need to keep buying this for as long as they make it because this is how I want my skin to look all the time. I'm very happy to do so as well. So Glow Recipe described this in their own words as a skincare makeup hybrid that visibly brightens skin and delivers an effortless glow instantly and over time while helping to reduce hyperpigmentation and without leaving a grey cast. So I immediately was like, this is very similar, sounds similar to Glossier's Future Dew, and I hated that. Glow Recipe actually sent this to me and they actually said they weren't sure if I was going to like this because they saw my review of Glossier Future Dew and I was like, I maybe won't then. This is what it should have been. Future Dew feels like makeup. It feels like oil with some glitter in it. Whereas this feels just like a hydrating layer of glowy skincare that I love to finish off my routine with. That doesn't leave me looking greasy and shiny. This contains glycerin and sodium hyaluronate for that hydration. Niacinamide to help even out skin tone and brighten the skin tone as well. And to be honest, they're the only ingredients I care about because the highlight of this product is the way it looks on the skin. This could have no beneficial ingredients in, not harmful obviously, but no beneficial ingredients, and I still use it just as like a layer of like cosmetic elegance. I'm just here for the natural finish, the natural glow that this product gives me that so many other products promise but can never deliver. I was reading the reviews and some people describe this as greasy, and I have to completely disagree. If you use too much, coming from an oily person, if you use too much, yes, it can be greasy, but you use like I use like half a pump on my forehead, half a pump here and here, then one pump down here. And it's just so, so nice. It's just so nice and natural and not oily. And I also have to compare this to Glossier's Future Dew because what's nice about this one is it hasn't got a tint to it and it's nice and lightweight, so it's great for all skin tones and types. It's free from mica, glitter, or crushed pearl, so it hasn't got that, you know, I'm going to a year 7 disco, I put glitter on my face kind of finish to it. That's not where the artificial glow comes from. And it doesn't turn into an oily mess during the day because it's not oily like Glossier's Future Dew. Sorry. They've just hit the nail on the head with this so much, and I've actually re-added some Glow Recipe products to my skincare routine, my forever changing skincare routine, because it reminds me how much I enjoy using their products. Products that look great, feel great on the skin, and actually do their job. And those really are the products that just do what they're supposed to do and do what they promise. If you want to see more product reviews, good and bad, check out the videos here. And for just some general light entertainment, check out the videos here. And I'll see you over there.